Hi guys, this is Devnath from Officers IAS Academy, and you're watching our series, How to Read the Hindu Newspaper. In this series, I've been explaining how to read the newspaper in the first place and what to pick out and what to ignore, right? For the examination perspective. If you've already read the newspaper for this day, this video should serve as a checklist for you to find out whether you've covered all that is needed to cover from today's newspaper. If you have not already read the newspaper, use this video as a guideline as to know what to read in the paper. So we're taking up today's paper, Tuesday, December 4th, and this is the Tamil Nadu edition, Chennai in particular. The first article talks about court restraining Rajapaksa from functioning as PM. This relates to an internal politics of Sri Lanka. Just know what is happening within that country. There is political turmoil within that country. It interestingly talks also about co-warranto, right? The co-warranto petition of Sri Lanka will not be tested in your examination, but you can relate this to your own static portions and polity as to what the co-warranto petition in our constitution talks about. There are different writ petitions, right? Habeas corpus, co-warranto, certiorari, mandamus, etc., right? So link it to your static and find out what co-warranto writ petition in our constitution talks about. Otherwise, just generally know what this article is saying. The next important article is Qatar to quit OPEC next month. This is a very important article for you to read. Find out what the OPEC is in the first place, Organization of the Petroleum Exporting Countries. Who are the members of this organization? Where are they located? Take your atlas and find out where these countries are located in the atlas, right? Good, important article for you to read in today's paper. Choking capital. In this picture, it talks about, in the description to this picture, it talks about the Yamuna. It talks about the air quality in the national capital. It talks about the air quality being in the very poor category. It talks about the National Green Tribunal. So these are all information directly related to your environmental ecology static portions. So find out what are the other air quality standards are, what the NGT does to make the air quality better, what the different standards mean, etc. Right? The other articles in this side of the paper is not necessary. Moving quickly to the next page. This Chennai News. This article is very important. A close bond with fossil fuel. Yesterday we saw a similar article. The single-use plastics are to be banned from January 1st. So Hindu is giving up a lineup of what are the alternatives to plastic and different aspects associated with plastic. This is a very good infographic for you to read. You can pick out a lot of information, right? Definitely read this article. The other articles in this page are not necessary. Moving quickly to the next page. In this page today, there are not much important information from the UPSC examination perspective. So this page can be ignored in today's paper. Moving on to the fourth page. This is mostly Tamil Nadu news, and the news items in this page today are mostly political, so it is not required from the examination perspective. Again, Tamil Nadu news. This again is not necessary from the examination perspective. This talks about HC order notice to Vedanta on pollution of Appar. Just find out what this article is about and what the pollution related issues are in general. We've had the Sterlite protests in Tamil Nadu. This relates to that also. Find out how companies are polluting the environment and what is being done in the country to curb that, right? The other articles are not necessary in this page. Moving on to the next page. The articles here are mostly political in nature. It talks about the other states in the southern part of the country apart from Tamil Nadu. Most of the articles in this are not necessary from the examination point of view. But here, this article, Centre backtracks on Polavaram hearing. This Polavaram issue has been in news for quite some time now. Find out what this Polavaram issue is, where Polavaram is, how it affects the people in Odisha and Chhattisgarh, etc. Good for you to know. Quickly moving on to the next page, the Nation page. Here we have an article about the GSAT, 5.8 ton GSAT 11 ready for launch. This is a very important article for you to read from the point view of satellite launches, etc. Right? And it gives out very, very good information. It says that this satellite will support BharatNet connectivity. Find out how it supports BharatNet connectivity. And in this, it gives out, it is the heaviest satellite to, the heaviest Indian communication satellite, right? So that is good for you to know, but the specific number, this the tonnage of the satellite itself is not necessary. And even if UPSC seems to test it, usually these numbers are wrong, because it is sufficient for you to know the range, that it is around 5,800 kilograms, but 5854, that specific number is not necessary. Information such as these is very important to meet unprecedented data demands. So the application of the satellite is what is important, right? So you can skim through that article and find out the applications of that GSAT 11 satellite. The other news items in this page are not necessary specifically. NGT levies 25 crores penalty on Delhi government. It talks about the CPCB also. We saw in the first page there was a picture of the Yamuna with a smog cover. Find out what it is about, how pollution is happening in Delhi, what are the causes of this pollution, what are the consequences, what is the CPCB doing about it, what is the National Green Tribunal doing about it. These are things that you need to consider as you read this article. The other articles are not necessary. Moving quickly to the editorial page. The editorial page is considered the most difficult page. Moving on to the editorial page. The editorial page is considered, is dreaded the most, because it takes a lot of time to read the editorial page, right? But if you follow the methods that I discuss with you to read the editorial page, you can quickly finish it off in a matter of 15 minutes. 15 minutes. Yeah, you can definitely do it within 15 to 20 minutes, right? So going to today's editorial page, first of all, uneasy feels. Now this editorial talks about farmers' distress, it talks about the agricultural chain needing a reboot. So it's a very important article for you to consider. Read all that is there within this. Just get a sense of what it is talking about. And then there is this tariff truce. There has been a trade war between US and China in the recent past, and now they've announced a truce. Find out how this is beneficial to the global economy. How is it beneficial to Indian economy in particular? So this is also a very good article for you to read in today's editorial page. When you come to this, two Punjabs, one South Asia. India-Pakistan rapprochement and the South Asian future requires subnational engagement starting with Punjab. Skim through the article and find out what it wants to talk to you about. What is the agenda of the article in the first place? What is the objective of the article in the first place? And then there are very, very important terms within this article also for you to take up and use in your mains answers, right? It talks about state centralism, and it talks about regionalism also. Regionalism now is a specific topic in your UPSC syllabus, and you cannot find definite source materials to read about regionalism as such. It is only from articles such as these where you can gain some knowledge about regionalism and develop from that, and using your own thinking and write answers, right? So definitely read this article, skim through it. You don't have to read it word by word. Skim through it and find out what it wants to say and take the ideas and make notes, right? Secular democracy in peril. This again talks about how the secular democracy in the country is being challenged. Indian politics today reminds one of the first decade of the existence of Pakistan. So this relates to communalism, which also finds place in your UPSC syllabus, right? Read this article. You don't have to take the opinions of the author, Mr. Mohammed Ayub, as such, but you can use these ideas to embellish your answers in the mains paper. Skim through the article and gain as much information as you can from it, right? Moving on to the next page, the OPET page, make planning fashionable again. The withdrawal of the Indian state from economic decision making has had consequence on the industry. This is a very, very interesting and important article in today's newspaper. It gives out the history of planning in our country, the development of planning in our country, how it was conceptualized and how it has helped the Indian economy. And now with planning losing track as a policy foothold, the author argues that planning has to be made fashionable again. It has to be brought into account again, right? So read this article. It will definitely help you gain a lot of knowledge, right? Again, this article, The Boundaries of Ethics, it talks about the ethics of gene editing. Is it ethical or non-ethical? So this is directly related to paper 4, GS paper 4 in your UPSC mains. A question can also find place in GS paper 3 because it relates to science and technology. It talks about how gene editing is not ethical. It's not an ethical practice. Find out what the reasons the author of the article puts forward to say so, right? And gather information from that. It also talks about CRISPR-Cas9. So that found place in this year's UPSC prelims as well. So it's an important article for you to read for the day. The other articles in this page are not necessary, particularly from the examination perspective. Here it talks about fake news. Just know what fake news is, and this is generally a journalist's account of how fake news affected him, Deepu, Sebastian, Edmond, right? So find out what fake news is, how fake news is affecting, has different effects on different sectors of the country, right? Moving on to the main news page, usually political news and information find place in this page, and when it is political, it is not necessary for the UPSC exam. That is what I've been repeatedly telling. But in this article, there's something that the Prime Minister has talked about, the Bishnoi community, Jodhpur Bishnoi community, for its dedication to the cause of environment protection, recalled the historical incident of 1730. Right now, find out what this 1730 incident was related with your history static, and find out more about the Bishnoi community. Right, it can also find a place in as an environment and ecology question. You can quote this also in your UPSC mains answers. Good thing for you to know. The other articles in this section are not necessary in particular. We come directly to ex-CEC flags increase in cash seizures. This is an opinion of the outgoing Chief Election Commissioner, Mr. O.P. Rawat. He is given certain observations. This is an important article for you to read. He's also talked about the government should take measures like putting a cap on the election expenditure of political parties and bring in more transparency. Again, this is a point that you could use in your answers, right? How can how can the government make political parties functioning more transparent? What measures should be taken to make elections fair and free in this country? These are things that you should consider. Again, the Maratha bill, it has been in news for quite some time now. Go read what this article wants to tell you about, and associate how the Maratha giving reservation to the Maratha community is affecting different things, right? How it will give rise to demands from other communities as well. What are the constitutional provisions regarded to this? Things as these, it is very good for you to consider. The other articles are not necessary. In this article, there's the information in this article as such is not necessary, but it talks about the Bhima Koregaon violence to see how serious, right? This mentioned, just when this should bring to your mind, because the Bhima Koregaon issue has been discussed repeatedly in newspapers and it is constantly in current affairs. So find out what the history behind this Bhima Koregaon battle is, what the Marathas did, what the British did, etc., etc., right? And there's also a general tribal resurgence in the country. We've had the Pathalgadi rebellion, we've had the Bhima Koregaon issue, we've had the Paika rebellion being termed as the first war of independence. So this will make UPSC frame questions in this theme, right? Whenever UPSC wants to pick questions, this theme could be used, tribal rebellions in modern India, tribal rebellions before 1730 or in 1700s, etc. So you can definitely pay attention to what's happening there. Moving on to the next page, India remains the cornerstone of our foreign policy. This is an article, this is an interview by the foreign ministry, Bhutan's new foreign minister, Mr. Tandi Dorji. Is a very important article because it directly relates to India, and it also talks about the BBIN, Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Nepal Motor Vehicles Agreement. Find out what this agreement is, find out what this agreement will do, and what it means to India in terms of regional cooperation also, right? Important article for you to read. Moving forward, the other articles, In this page are not particularly necessary. This article, services agree on permanent chair, chief of staff's committee to get full-time head to improve joint manship. Find out what chief of staff committee is in the first place, what joint manship is, and how it will help in integrating the forces of our country, the Navy, the Army, and the Air Force, right? Good and important article for you to read. Moving forward, usually I always specify that the international page, the world page in the Hindu, has to be read, and the articles in it have to be read only if it has an India focus, an India accent. But in today's paper, the articles are of a different nature, and it has an India aspect associated with it remotely, and is good for you to know. For example, this US-China ties make big leap forward, says Trump. In this, there might be information about how the truce might help the global economy. So skim through the article and pick out all the information that you can regarding this issue. And then we have this Trump writes to Imran, seeks help in Afghan talks. Now, this is a very, very interesting piece, because there's a lot at stake for India in Afghanistan in terms of internal security and regional cooperation also. So in this article, it is about India's regional cooperation, internal security, etc. What is the equation between India, Afghanistan, Pakistan's government, the Taliban, and the US government? These are very interesting things for you to consider and to know also. So this is an important article for you to read. Moving forward, the other articles in this page are not necessary in particular from the examination point of view. This gas remains our top priority, says Qatar. This is a continuation from what we saw in the first place. This is Qatar's reasons for quitting the OPEC. Find out what these reasons are, and find out how it plays a role in the global oil manufacturing and global oil prices also. Right, and when you find countries mentioned in terms of organization, immediately go look it up in your atlas, because this is how questions will be framed in the examination also. Map based questions in UPSC question papers are not given to you from somewhere. There is always a context to it. Somehow it would have found mention in the newspapers in the preceding year. There would be some important development regarding these countries. This is how UPSC frames map based questions, right? It is not random. So go immediately check where Qatar is in the map, and West Asia and Middle Asia has Middle East has constantly been in news for quite some time now. It's good for you to check in the map and find out what the seas are surrounding these countries, what the straits are, and what the gulfs are, etc. Moving forward, we go to the business page of the Hindu paper. Outlook for banks weak but stable, says Moody's. Find out what this Moody's is, what it does. It's a credit rating agency. The outlook being weak is based on something, right? They cannot just say that the outlook is weak on random basis. There will be a definite basis, and the basis is NPAs, which it talks about here also, non-performing loans, which will help shore up resolved non-performing loans, which help shore up asset quality. So find out how non-performing assets cause a dent in the country's reputation and a dent in the investments coming into the country, etc. Right? Jetley preaches for easing trade barriers. Good important article for you to read. Find out what these trade barriers are and why Jetley is pitching for easing these trade barriers. CSO source data must be respected. This is an article which talks about an interview with the Finance Commission Chairman, Mr. N.K. Singh. The N.K. Singh committee has constantly been in news for quite some time now. It is good for you to read this article. And it talks about fiscal federalism, right? Now, we have this cooperative federalism being mentioned in our syllabus for UPSC mains. Now, find out what this fiscal federalism is. And he said that fiscal federalism faced 8 primary challenges. It is good for you to know these challenges and make notes of it also, so that you can use it in your mains answers. Moving forward, rupee goes above 70 as oil prices rises. Find out how the rupee is weakening as oil prices rise up. what is the relation between oil prices going up and the rupee weakening, etc. This cause and consequence thing should be definitely learned from newspapers, right? Even if you can read it from different source materials, only if you read it from the, when you read it from the newspaper, the memory retention is much more, and it will definitely come to you in when you take the examination. Good for you to read this part of the paper. Moving forward, the next page of the next business page, manufacturing PMI hits 11th month high in November. Find out what this purchasing manager's index is. What are the other indices to measure manufacturing output in the country? Find out who rolls out this purchasing manager's index in the first place, right? Good article for you to read and learn a lot of things. The other articles in this page are not particularly necessary. I've always maintained that government ads such as these are very important from the UPSC prelims perspective, because they give direct information, right? This article in particular talks about an integrated terminal building coming up in the Vijayawada airport. That information is not necessary, but it says it under Udaan scheme, right? Now we have this Udaan scheme mentioned here. When you read schemes in isolation, you read so many other schemes that are there rolled out by the government, and you tend to forget most of its purposes. But when you gain information from government ads such as these, it will be a very, very good impact for you to understand about these schemes in particular. For example, Udaan seeks to link underserved airports in the country, right? And there's a picture of the airplane. So if at all there was any question in the UPSC prelims in the coming year about this Udaan scheme, you could definitely link it to the airport, the aviation industry, and domestic airports being made to serve better, right? It's good for you to look at these ads. It takes very little time. It is interesting also. Moving to next is the sports page. I've always told that sports is completely not necessary from the UPSC examination perspective, prelims or mains. If you're interested in sports, you can go read it at the end of the day after you finished all your work. Moving forward, we come to the last page of the Hindu newspaper. Again, this is an RBI ad, an ad by the Reserve Bank of India. It talks about the PIN, OTP, CVV, UPI PIN, etc. While this might seem very insignificant and inconsequential from the examination perspective, UPSC might frame questions from this also. The differences between OTP and CVV, and OTP and PIN, and what is a two-factor authentication? How does this help in improving the security of our payments, etc.? These are things that should strike you. Not that points from this article will directly come in the UPSC paper, but when you consider this this advertisement and put your mind to it and think about different aspects of that ad, there will be a lot of knowledge development and you can gain more information, right? A good ad to read and consider. The last article, Einstein's letter to God on sale, while it is not directly related to your UPSC examination prelims or mains, it's very interesting to know what Einstein thought about God, right? So when you have some spare time, please go look at this article. Finally, moving to the last ad, while the BMW mentioned here is not at all necessary, it gives out a very, very beautiful line. It says, realize your dream. I hope all of you realize your dream of becoming administrators of this country and serve the country to your fullest ability. All the best.